Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science on Location. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. They say chemistry is a lot like baking. You start out with the same typical ingredients, and then you add your own special flavors to get it to your final unique product. Water has so many different types of particles, but they all have one common ingredient, silica. To really understand what goes into making a particle, we need to take a trip to the manufacturing floor and talk with the experienced engineers who do this job every day.
Hi, Diane. How are you? Diane, you know Jen. Jen, this
Hi,
is Diane.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Now, Diane, today we're talking about how we manufacture particles in the Taunton plant. And it all begins with you because you scheduled the production. So can you tell Jen how you do all that?
Well, yeah, I'd be happy to do that. Let me wrap this up. Just reviewing this for tomorrow's meeting, and we'll go on to synthesis.
Okay, let's take a look.
Okay, so this is the bulk synthesis office. This is where all the scheduling takes place for our manufacturing.
So Diane, you make a lot of products here. How on earth do you keep track of all of them and know when you need to make things?
Well, planning dictates what we're gonna make and the quantities that we'll make, and they cut factory orders for us. Mm-hmm. And we generate a schedule, so we have a weekly synthesis schedule. And this is one of the tools that we use. This tracks every batch that's in process and where it is as far as QC analysis.
Wow.
So we can know if it passes dryness, if it's ready to package or proceed to a next step. And we also have the Delta V screen, which operators can go on and look at their reactor and see just where the reaction is in the status and how much time is left. And so right now we have the 30-gallon autoclave that we're monitoring the process.
I know where that vessel is. That is in Suite 2.
Could we go take a look?
Darn tootin'. Let's go.
Let's go.
Hi, Beth. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Beth, you know Jen?
Hi, Beth.
Nice to see you.
Actually, we were just upstairs with Diane, and she had your instrument actually on her screen. Can you tell me a little bit more about what you're working on?
Sure. This is an autoclave. What we do with this is a pore ripening step.
Okay.
This gives us a more consistent pore volume, which in our customers' columns gives them a very repeatable and reliable separation.
Great. So after this, it goes into the column?
No. We still have to clean it and dry it. Then we have to size it to give it a nice, narrow particle size distribution.
And the sizing area would be in Suite 3.
Off to Suite 3.
You bet. Let's go. Hey, Paul, how are you doing?
Good.
Paul,
good
you know Jen?
You. Yes,
Hi, Paul.
How are you doing?
To see
good
you.
To see you.
Would you like to talk to Jen a little bit about what we do in Suite 3 with sizing particles?
Yeah, so after we make the fresh-made material, we'll bring it over and we autoclave it in Suite 2. Once that happens, we make different sizes because different companies like a different size material. So here we make anything from a 1.7 micro material up to 55 to 105 micro material. The process that we have here is classification where we send the material in, there's a centrifuge process where there's a rotor in there spinning the material around. The heavy stuff goes to the outside, the small stuff goes to the inside, and we separate them into two buckets. Once we go get them into two buckets, then we take a sample, we go up to the QC lab, and we have a Coulter, which is a graphical representation of what we're doing. And this will tell us where we are, and so we can keep taking the material and size it to exactly the exact dimensions that people are looking for in their material.
Wow, it sounds like the process of making a particle is anything but simple.
Jen, we only cover two steps. It's anything but simple. You only know the half of it.
Maybe you could take me through it on a whiteboard.
You bet. Let's go. Now, this is more or less the process we go through in terms of making the bulk material. It's around, for most products, 6 to 8 or 9 steps. And it begins from the simplest raw materials. We make our fresh-made particles. We then pore enlarge the sizes to make it more repeatable. Then we take it to Suite 3 in sizing. After we size it, we then acid treat it to remove the metals. In some cases, an autoclaving effect. Then we put on the bonding, which is actually the chromatographic media and does the separations for our customers. After we're done all these steps, it's important to know we QC test each step to be sure we have good materials for each step along the way.
Making a particle is anything but simple, and it goes much further beyond just the particle. It's also the science and care that goes into packing that particle just right to get highly reproducible and robust results. If you want help in choosing what particle is right for you, check out the link below and let our column coach help you. Join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science on Location.